Fair point indeed. Mr. Subir, just stay with us because I also have a very special guest, Mr. Vijayshekhar Sharma of Paytm, joining us right here. Thanks very much and congratulations from all of us at ET Now for being yet another payments bank in the country. 11 of you are the chosen few. So thank you very much for sparing time. But what sort of an opportunity do you see for yourself? What sort of challenges do you envisage? Okay, the line has gotten disconnected with Mr. Sharma. They need to work on their technology before they get going with the bank. So Rajiv Arora, I'm going to come back to you. And we were speaking to Chola Mandalam about acquisition of potential customers. They have an obvious advantage because, you know, they're already an existing bank. They have a lot of access to farmers, like Mr. Subir was pointing out. How different is the strategy going to be for, say, a Reliance Industries or for a Dilip Shanghvi or for an Airtel, for that matter, and, of course, for yourself? Is Mr. Rajiv Arora with us?
Hello. Hello.
Hi, Mr. Arora, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
So the question that I'm asking is that we were discussing acquisition of potential customers. How, and Mr. Subir of Chola Mandalam was essentially saying how they already have existing customers in their banks, they have access to farmers who will be potential customers, and of course they will ransack the entire universe to get many more. But how different will acquisition of customers be for players like a Reliance Industry, or Dilip Shanghvi, and Airtel, or Vodafone? Do you envisage a situation, including yourselves, where players will be chasing specific verticals going ahead?
See, if you look at Fino as an organization, in the last 9 years, we have been only in the space of financial inclusion. So our segment per se has only been mass market segment per se. And we have acquired close to 95 million customers on behalf of different banks in this segment. So we have the experience and we know the behavior of this customer, and we know the behavior of this customer from a payment perspective.
Fair point indeed. Mr. Vijayshekhar Sharma of Paytm joins us as well on the phone line. Thanks, Mr. Sharma, for being with us. Congratulations from all of us at ET Now for being in the banking space of India now. It's a payments bank that's coming up. You've got 10 other competitors. What sort of challenges and opportunities do you envisage at this stage?
Thank you so much, first of all. And it's an honor to be chosen among these 11 few. And I'm sure we will do justice to the opportunity that RBI and government has given us. And I believe that we're taking it from the consumer side. We're taking it from smartphone, mobile internet consumer side. And we've had experience with how consumers are transacting using our platform. And we're proud that today 100 million users have become on our Paytm platform. So we want to transfer as many of them and upgrade them to the payment bank possibly. And I mean, as Paytm, our vision has always been that by 2020, we want to bring 500 million Indians to the mainstream economy. And I'm very happy and proud that government believed in us and gave us an opportunity to do this.
Fair point indeed. And, you know, you are a niche player, and so are some of the others that we are speaking to right now who've been in the finance space. But players like a Reliance Industries, players like a Dilip Shanghvi and Airtel, I know they do some bit of Airtel Money, and Vodafone does some M-Pesa. How is the competition going to really flare up in this segment? Because there are some who have exposure to finance, there are some who have some kind of an exposure to banking and finance, and there are others who are abjectly new, but of course they are players with deep pockets, a Reliance Industries, for instance.
So I mean, look, it is ultimately going to be a technology business. I believe that the next wave or the necessity for this country is how do you solve large financial opportunities, problem and opportunity both using technology. And I believe as native technology player, we sort of have an edge there. That said, I think everybody whom you named is incredible resourced person and team, and we don't want to believe that it is a place for one or two. We believe that it's a place for everyone to coexist, and the more number of players will create a vibrant ecosystem. So we welcome everybody as a co-player, and at the same time, all the banks are also capably there. So I believe that together we can solve this opportunity and problem of country that we only have 200 million banked people. So we have to bring these next 500 million people on the platform. So there's a lot for everyone there.
A fair and a very, very valid point indeed, Mr. Sharma. The next obvious question is that as you go and hit the ground running in the next 18 months, that's the time period you have before you set up these payments banks, what sort of an infrastructure investment or what sort of an initial investment do you think this is going to entail? What kind of a model are you looking at this stage?
We're looking at technology-led and software-led business model where we add banking correspondent and branches, local branches in addition to that. We believe that consumer trust is when consumers see someone there. So we're going to add a lot of banking correspondent and local small branches. And I believe the best part will be that consumers who have committed to the smartphone and phone are our customers, so which means consumers' commitment already exists that they are ready to use technology. And who better than some of us who know that how consumers are accepting technology in today's environment. So we are very proud that our technology-led business solution will be one of the differentiating factors for us, and we want to spend all that is needed. I mean, we are well-capitalized as of now, and we have put the financial plan in front of RBI, and we believe that we can take care of it far more than what we think in the upfront days would be required. So we have investors, we have zero debt on us, and we have ample amount of capitalization. So hopefully we'll be able to do it well.
As for the RBI release, there are going to be stringent guidelines that you will have to meet. You know, India's banking regulator is supposed to be one of the most vigilant in the world, and which is perhaps why our banking industry is very safe. How tough is it going to be for players like yourselves to adhere to some of those norms, really, Mr. Sharma?
I really want to tell you this, that our experience with RBI has been the most phenomenal regulator experience ever in many industries that I personally have worked into. And I can tell you that I'm very proud that we have a regulator like RBI who is vigilant, because it doesn't take a lot for people to create problems for gullible consumers out there. And so I'm very proud that there is RBI who is going to vigilantly check everything that is happening in the ecosystem. And that is why we believe players who will remain sincere will play long ball. We are here for long haul.
I'm certain that you're here for the long haul. You've done a phenomenal success with your business as far as Paytm is concerned. We wish you the very best going forward. But I urge you to answer a very quick question for me. Because this business is going to entail very technology-intensive services, and you know there will be lesser focus on physical infrastructure, do companies like, say, a Tech Mahindra stand to gain, or are they at advantage because they already have a tech infrastructure in place?
They should be at advantage. I believe that every company who's going to lead it with technology and their capability in technology will definitely be an advantage. I think if you look at us, again, we are doing the same. We are claiming the same, that we have technology product that has acquired customers. So anybody who's playing with technology as a strength is the superior play to play.
A very quick follow-up question, Mr. Sharma, really is that we were talking about unbanked India, and nearly 60% of India is either underbanked or unbanked, but there are geographical hubs that are particularly underbanked or unbanked. In this case, the RBI wants to push the Northeast region. Will your focus, to begin with, be in some geographies over others, and which geographies will those be?
I think Central India or Northeast are some of those areas which are very much they wanted somebody to focus, and we have said these are the key focus areas for us too. So, you know, the best opportunity is when you're not competing with many, because when you're competing with many, then you're looking at what one can offer over another, while these are total virgin. I think the telecom of this industry, this country has shown that there is a great opportunity, and I'm sure that there will be payment banks that will show that truly there is a great opportunity for next business line, which is financial services there.
And you've got 10 odd big competitors there, which are Vodafone, Mr. Shangvi, Reliance, you've got Department of Post. Do stay with us, Mr. Sharma, because you're giving us a lot of insight into this new business model, into this new banking era in India. So do stay with us, because I also have Mr. Divanji, Partner Financial Services, EY, to give us a broader picture of really the banking space in India. Thanks very much.